Hello ladies and gents, it's SpoonyPizzas here with another Pro Evolution Soccer 2019 video. And today I'm excited to bring you some breaking news around the Master League announcements that came out today. I will leave a link in the description below if you want to read the article yourself. But I'm just going to cover off the main points and also share the things I'm most excited about. So let's get straight into this. Okay, so there are a few screenshots on the website that I'm going to extract. So you can see here that the actual Master League looks very, very similar. A few of the icons have changed from what I can tell from looking at this, but not a whole lot. Now, on the website, it does say addition of a newsfeed. Now, they had the newsfeed initially anyway, but if I read this here, a newsfeed will be added to the Master League menu that will host videos, such as press conference for a newly signed coach, winning a competition, being awarded an individual title, and moments that highlight important milestones of the club you're managing. So that was the key thing for me, was the videos. Now, we didn't have any videos in the past, it was just more or less still pictures, so that's gonna be quite good. And also you're gonna see other things from other clubs that are going on, which is gonna be good, because in PES 2018 it was all about your club, and there wasn't anything about any other clubs, managers moving on or anything like that. So that's going to be, that's definitely new and something I'm looking forward to. This next screenshot is actually one of my favourites. So when you're doing training in PES 2018, you have got the option to do focus training. But literally, you can only choose one of these options, like shooting, passing, dribbling, defence, speed, physical, goalkeeper ability. But you can't actually put points in certain things, which is absolutely great, because this is going to mean that you know, you're going to be able to put points in passing and shooting for, like, you know, say you're like an attacking midfielder or whatever, or defence and passing for like a defensive midfielder. So it's going to be really good. I think it's going to be like allow you to really hone the attributes that you really want for that type of player. I still hope they have the way you could sort of define a role of a player. I'm sure they have. Because this is when you just go straight into the focus training mode, but that you can still select, you know, sort of anchorman training, so they eventually get the anchorman playing card and he'll sit and hold and protect the defense. So hopefully they've still got that, but this is great. This is great where you can put, like I say, you can put points into certain things and you can see the impact that it's going to have on the actual training stats here. So he's got one for speed, you can see there. The speed, explosive power, and unwavering balance have also got one up. So, and looking at that, we can see here that there's a few new, there's just the one actually. Looking at this, there's one new stat that's changed, and it's unwavering balance. So they've replaced strength on the ball with unwavering balance, and it's more or less the same thing. So before we had strength on the ball. And a lot of people got confused what's the difference between strength on the ball and physical contact. Well, the strength on the ball is obviously how easy it is to knock you off the ball when you've got possession of the ball. And then I guess the physical contact stat used to go against the strength on the ball. But now that's unwavering balance. And that's more or less the same thing. It used to, in previous versions of the PES, it used to be called body balance and things like this. So unwavering balance. It's a bit of a ridiculous name, if I'm honest, but I get where they're coming from. It's just like how easy it is to knock that player off the ball. And that's the only one I can see looking at this that's changed. Yeah, no, everything else is pretty much the same. So that's a really good screenshot, and that's probably one of my favourites. So, yeah, let me know what you think in the comments about this focus training. I think it's going to be... I think that's the best thing I've seen so far in the Master League, to be honest. And it's going to help shape the players how I want them to sort of develop, which is really good. Okay, for this next screenshot, I'm just going to read off the website. So, improved negotiation system and budget management. Now, I'm hoping that allows you to adjust the sort of percentage between transfer budget and salary budget, a bit like they have in FIFA, which would be really good. And by the sounds of that, what they wrote on the website, that's pretty much what I'd assume. The last bit was added a resale and clean sheet options. So strategy is needed not only on the pitch, but also with club management. So you can see here, there is a selling on option. So the way the selling on option works is, say for instance we had Lionel Messi, we sell him for 100 million and we include a selling on option of 50%. So what'll happen there is, if the next club that you sold him to sell Lionel Messi again for another 100 million, you will get 50% of that fee they sold him for. So they will have to pay you 50 million. So basically you'd get 150 million. I also like how they split out the negotiations between the club and the player. Whereas before you sort of had to adjust things and you weren't sure if it was the player upsetting or the club. So now you get a clear image that you can see here that PES United have 82% chance of signing him. So they could increase that by offering a greater transfer fee. And you can see there the negotiations with the actual player, Zaranadona, has a 93% chance of signing. So you could probably lower his wage a little bit or increase his goal bonus or reduce the release fee or whatever. And you could increase his contract length to adjust that percentage, much like you did in the in PES 2018. So yeah, that's looking really good. I like the changes they made. It's a lot. It's a much clearer image. And they're definitely working on the, you can see they're clearly working on the menu, so it's looking good. And lastly is team role and personality. So I'll just read what it says on the website. It says, review each player's personality traits. The personality of a player can be made up of from one of four personality traits, and their team role will be based on their personality. So you can see here with Mohamed Salah, he's got the superstar team role, and you can see there his personality, because of that superstar team role, he's a lone wolf, so he's not a team player. He's passionate instead of composure. He's physical over technique, which I'm kind of surprised by, because I thought he'd be more technique over physical, and he's got more instinct than insight. So, You see just below there, you've got the team role effect. So he's having a really good impact on finances. So he's adding a bit of a bonus to either your transfer budget or your salary budget. Probably more like the salary budget, like in PES 2018. And you can see there his conditions not great. His growth, he's still growing, but not a very fast rate with 2 for growth. And then he's got team spirit for 1. And that probably sort of is reflected with that, him being a lone wolf as well. So, yeah, that's. I'm not sure how big an impact that has. I mean, for PES 2018, it didn't really have that much of an effect. I didn't find these roles. So, yeah, it'd be interesting to see if this has a greater impact on the gameplay and what it actually means. Whether it affects you playing as a player, because I mean, like, if he's a lone wolf, what's going to stop you making a pass? So yeah, I don't think it's going to have that much effect if you're actually in control. It might do if the AI is controlling that player. You know, being a lone wolf, you might go on more dribbling runs, but I imagine that's going to be underneath the player skills. You sort of had that, I can't remember what it's called now, something like AI traits or something along those lines, and that would determine how the player was played by the AI. So they might have amazing run or speedy bullet or whatever it's called, and that would sort of determine how they played on the pitch. So yeah, I'm not too sure how big an impact this will have, but yeah, we'll have to wait and see. So, and that's pretty much it for the news. There's nothing really much more to add, so I'll leave it there. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Cheers, guys. Bye-bye.